Hello everyone. Today's topic is initial and final values of basic electrical elements. So why it is required? Because I will tell you what with one example. That is, if this will be the time plot. Okay, you everyone know at this point it is suppose t equal to 0. Okay, t equal to 0, it means suppose at t equal to 0 I want to operate some circuit. So okay, whenever we have some circuit we are going to operate, it means we are moving some switch, we are going to close the switch, we are going to open the switch. Okay, suppose that time it t equal to 0. Okay, before t equal to 0, suppose that is 0 minus time, it means okay, before operation. Okay, this will be the before operation. Okay, it means okay, suppose we are going to operate some circuit, and if it is initially charged, we know that in electrical we have some elements which can store the energy. Okay, either in any form. So if we going to operate that circuit at t equal to 0, it may happen that before operation it has some energy. Okay, and for t greater than 0, this will be the t greater than or equal to 0. Because of this storing or stored energy, it may happen that sometimes the circuit misbehaves, or we can say circuit will not operate as we are thinking. Okay, so we have to recognize that at t equal, as soon as we are going to switch on, what will happen in the circuit. Okay, for the particular very short time, this will happen for the particular very short time. After some time it may work, but for this very short time you can say t equal to 0 plus, it will be the very small time at the time of operation, or you can say it is a transient period. Okay, what will happen? Suppose I will take one example, not electrical, but let's take a physical example, or you can say mechanical or any example. You are going to start running. Okay, now you have capacity to run 5 km per hour or 10 km per hour, but at the starting, can you start your speed at t equal to 0 with 5 km, or after 10 or 15 minutes your speed will be increased? You know my point. Okay, because in our body we have some moment of inertia, we have some body weight, so instantly our speed cannot change to 0 to 5 km or 10 km per hour. It will increase gradually. This will again happen in the electrical engineering also. Now I will take one example of fan. Okay, what will be the speed of fan? It is 300 rpm. Okay, now as soon as you are going to switch on the fan, the instantly the speed is 300 rpm. No, why it is happen? Because of this moment of inertia, or you can say weight, or the element which can charge the energy. Okay, so this will happen due to this, and we are going to recognize this one. So we are going to know that what will be the initial condition of the circuits. Okay, now what are the basic electrical elements? We know that the basic electrical elements are R, L and C. Out of these three, the resistance which are not a device which store the energy, but an inductor and a capacitor. These two are the device which can store the energy. So once you charge the inductor and you will put it as a open circuit, it has some charge. Same way for the capacitor also. So whenever we are going to put in the circuit, it has some stored energy which it will release. So it will affect the performance of the circuit which we are made. Okay, so again, inductor will store the energy in form of current. Okay, inductor will store the energy in form of current, and capacitor will store the energy in form of voltage. You have to remember these three things. Resistance not store energy, inductor store the energy in form of current, capacitor store the energy in form of voltage. Okay, now we are going to find out the what will happen when we are going to switch on the inductor, when we are going to switch off the inductor, and what will happens. Okay, so initial and final value, it means I have to know what will be the condition at t equal to 0 plus as soon as we are going to switch on. Okay, 0 plus, I already told you what is t equal to 0 plus, and another t equal to infinite. So I require these two things, okay, for the basic electrical elements which are the basic electrical elements, that is resistance, inductance and capacitors. Okay, so one by one again I will start with the basic thing, that is resistance. Again, what will be the symbol? The symbol of resistance is this one. At t equal to 0 plus or t equal to any time, because resistance do not charge or do not store the energy, it always behaves as an resistance. Okay, so always t equal to 0 plus, you can say t equal to 0 plus or t equal to infinite, it has some resistance at each and every time. So it does not store the energy, so it behaves as resistance. But whenever we are having a inductor or capacitor, it may have some different values. Okay, so for the inductor, this one is over, resistance is over. Now we have inductor. Okay, inductor L. For the inductor L, we have two types of inductor. Okay, one is uncharged inductor. Inductance, that is L. Okay, and another is charge inductor L. Now what will its behavior at t equal to 0 plus and t equal to infinite? Now what will happen for t equal to 0 plus? If inductor is uncharged, it means it has no current. It has no current, or I is equal to 0. Okay, so what will happen at i equal to 0, when current is 0, when circuit is open circuited, at that time current is 0. So at t equal to 0 plus, inductor will behave as a open circuit if it is uncharged. Remember the condition, if it is uncharged. Okay, so if inductor is uncharged at t equal to 0 plus, it will behaves as a open circuit. Okay, now what will happen if we have charge inductor? Okay, what will happen if we have charge inductor? It means suppose I have one inductor which has some stored energy and its value is I0. Suppose its value is I0 and whatever the direction, in this direction. So this inductor, what will happen? This inductor behaves as a current source. Okay, this inductor behaves as a current source which has the same direction of the charge and which has the same value of the previously charged, that is I0. So at t equal to 0 plus inductor is charged, then it will be behaves as a current source. Okay, now what will happen for uncharged inductor at t equal to infinite and charged inductor at t equal to infinite? Okay, so one by one again, for uncharged inductor, now what will happen? Inductor is charging slowly, so slowly its value is increased. Now what will happen? At the infinite time it is fully saturated, so now it has no capacity to further store the energy. So what will happen? Whatever the energy supplied by the source, it will fully deliver to the load. Okay, so what will happen? It will supply the full current. So it behaves as a short circuit. Okay, so at t equal to infinite it behaves as a short circuit. Okay, now whatever for the charge inductor, now at t equal to infinite, if I am charging inductor from the zero value or at some value, the final value of the inductor is always a short circuit. Okay, so this is for the inductor. Okay, now another remaining, which is the next element, we have capacitor C. Again, it is a energy storing element. So we have two part, that is uncharged C, and another is charge C. Okay, so again we have two part for the capacitor. One is uncharged C and another is charged C. Now what will happen when capacitor is uncharged? Now in which form energy stored in capacitor? That will in the form of voltage. So uncharged capacitor, it means it has zero voltage. And when voltage is zero, when resistance is zero, I into R, so when R is equal to zero, the capacitor has a zero voltage and resistance is zero, it means it is short circuited. So at t equal to zero plus capacitor behaves as a short circuit if capacitor is uncharged. That will be the most important condition, that is if capacitor is uncharged, then it behaves as a short circuit. Okay, now what will happen for the charge capacitor? How energy is charged in the capacitor? It is in the form of voltage. Okay, so charge capacitor, this one is plus, this one is minus, and suppose voltage at the capacitor is V0. So it behaves as a voltage source. Okay, it behaves as a voltage source. Value of that voltage is V0, which it is previously charged. Okay, and what will be the sign? The sign is this one is positive, this one is negative. Okay, Now, at t equal to infinite, what will happen? At t equal to infinite, what will happen? Now, for the capacitor. Capacitor at t equal to infinite, suppose it is fully charged. Fully charged, it means it has the maximum potential. Okay. Now, it can deliver the voltage to the source. But how it can deliver? Okay, at t equal to infinite, what will happen? The source voltage, which are charging the capacitor, it has the same voltage of the capacitor. That means a capacitor has a same voltage of source voltage. So both voltages are same, both are going to supply power to each other. What will happen? Ultimately, both voltages are same in the opposite sign. So there is no current. No current, it means it behaves as a open circuit. It behaves as a open circuit. Okay. And for the charge capacitor, same case. If I will charge capacitor from the zero value, or if I will charge capacitor from the some particular value, it always a final value that will be the open circuit. So at t equal to infinite, both voltages are same, both are in opposite direction of the each other. So at then there will be no current. So no current, it means there is a open circuit between these two. Okay, so again you have to remember this table for three chapters. Okay, this table for the three chapters, for the initial condition chapter, second one is the first order chapter, and another is circuit analysis using Laplace transformation. So again, this table is most important part of the initial condition as well as first order, second order differential equation and for the Laplace circuit analysis. Okay.